with Charles Davis. As always, I'm Brandon Gaudin. Charles, you talk about storylines in this one. I think it begins and ends with our two quarterbacks, certainly two of the best in the business.
And nowadays, I don't think you can get by for long periods of time without a top-flight quarterback. The way the game is played, with all the responsibility he has and how the game flows through him, if he's not on the top of his game, your team's not going to benefit at all.
Just about time to rock as Toe gets ready to meet leather. And off we go in Madden Ultimate Team. And taken down just past the 20 at about the 21-yard line. Opening play and Stroud will throw it. Catch made by DeAndre Hopkins. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. And we see the emphasis early here. Get your star receiver involved, able to do it successfully.
Not a bad start to begin with, that's for sure. And to me, this play says, our guy is better than your guy's. Because you know, a player of his stature, he won't just be sent to puppet all game long. He's going to involve multiple people. And right away, they told the other team, guess what? He's just better.
So the ball moves into Lion territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 35-yard line. They'll run with Sanders up the middle. And nowhere to run on the interior of that defensive line. He'll get back only to the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. Back to throw. Here's Stroud. Eluding the pressure right. And this is caught inside the five. And in for the Ravens touchdown. DeAndre Hopkins, 35 yards. And the Ravens are on the board first here on the road in Tampa. Point after, right down the middle. And that makes the score 7-0. Here's the kick unit now for the Ravens as they'll send this one away. And we'll see a return here from the end zone. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. So first and 10 now from the 30. Here's Montana to throw. Wide open, Gronkowski. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. They will look to throw, Montana. That's to Dalvin Cook, his running back. And he's going to get this inside the 30. Joe Montana here going to the air on first down. And the throw left sideline here is caught, but they'll rule it incomplete. Couldn't keep his feet in. Second down. Montana. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. They get him to the ground right on the cusp of the red zone after a pickup of 5 or 6. To throw is Montana. Flush to his right. Pass taken in by his big tight end. And he is out of bounds right around the 10-yard line. First and goal and a chance to get that initial touchdown right back. They'll run with Cook. And a short pickup there down to about the 9. The ball situated at the 9, second and goal. Now Montana. This is caught. And in for the Lions touchdown. A 9-yard touchdown grab. And the Lions are able to match the opening drive touchdown against him with one of their own.
The as a general rule, quarterbacks don't want to lock in on a receiver before the ball is snapped. But in this case, based on the matchup he thought he was going to get, it was favorable for his tight end. He locked in on him early and found him for a touchdown.
Extra point splits the uprights, and we are tied at 7. Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. And they're going to mark that where it went out of bounds. So really good starting field position up past the 40-yard line. Good starting field position for them as they come up first and 10 at the 41-yard line. Play action. Stroud now. Sliding out of the pocket. And he's got his target. It's Vernon Davis. And he's brought down. This drive starting off on the right foot. 18 yards. So the ball moves from their own 41 to the other 41 here for first and 10. Stroud looking to throw. Forced out to his left. He's got to hit that to Moore. And he's brought down, but not before he reaches the 8-yard line. 34 yards that time. These two teams all tied after one. Raven football here as we begin quarter number 2. As they go to work on a first and goal. Let's go now. They'll run with Sanders. And he'll work his way closer to the goal line as he's got 5 down to the 3. So the ball position now at the 3. Here's second and goal. Now Stroud. Vernon Davis from 3 yards out, and the Ravens have taken the lead. There was a lot of zip on that pass, and baseball might have called that a frozen rope.
I like it when you bring the diamond into the game. I'm going back to the gridiron, had some heat on that bad boy. Sometimes you throw a touchdown pass, and sometimes
you throw, what, a touchdown strike?
There you go. That's my man, in concert.
Extra point right down the middle. And that makes the score 14-7. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And here comes a return from just beyond the goal line. Now a crease here as he's past the 30. He might take this all the way. He will take this all the way. Touchdown, Lions.
That was a special return, and it happened because he's a special returner. He has to have that approval from his special teams coach's head coach to bring it out of the end zone.
But let's be honest, a lot of times where they bring it out of the end zone like he did there, they don't have approval. I mean, I think a lot of times they do, but correct me if I'm wrong. Sometimes it's just a guy getting a feel, right?
Yeah, exactly right. What's the old adage? Sometimes you just have to know when to break the rules, and if you do, you're taking on some responsibility. But he was happy to do so there.
This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. And he'll be stopped up at the 25. The Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going. And right now, we've got a little bit of an offensive masterpiece going on. Both sides moving the football, scoring points. It's almost like somebody put the defense on rookie mode in this one. I mean, we haven't even left the first half, Charles, and we're certainly on pace for a shootout.
An excellent start for both offenses. The fans have to be enjoying this to see all these points go up on the board. As a former defender, you know I'm not enjoying this at all. But right now, both these teams just trading haymakers. Let's see if anyone slips up first. Can anyone counter with a nice little jab and get things going in their direction?
Another throw on second down, and this one incomplete as well. So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a 3rd and 10. Throwing now is Stroud. Being chased out left. And I think the ball's out. Offensively lucky there, able to keep the football, but now fourth down, so they'll have to boot it away.
I do think, though, they're going to look at this as a positive. One, they recovered the fumble, so they retained possession. But two, being able to punt it changes field position for them. Imagine if that turnover takes place there. Now your defense has to go onto the field and try and hold. Instead, they get a little breathing room.
What was he thinking there? It's easily intercepted. Picked off by Jamel Dean. Now he's free at the 35. He may go. And he will bring it back. An interception return for the Lions touchdown. Extra point attempt to come here. It's up and good, and that'll make the score 21-14. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. And it's a pretty good return here as they'll get this up to the 29. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And remember, they were just out here a moment ago through the pick six, so we'll see if they can take better care of the football this go around.
And sometimes, partner, I think it's almost better that you just throw the pick six and you come right back out on the field. You're not over on the sidelines dwelling for it for very long. You're not hearing everyone say, oh, hey, you'll get them next time. Hey, don't worry about it. All that stuff just goes right out the window. You're right back out on the field with a chance to atone.
On first down, here's Stroud. Steps away to his left. This will be caught downfield by Moore. And nothing to speak of there after the catch as they get him right to the ground at the 37. Stroud now on first and 10. And that is caught. It's Davis. And they're going to be set up down around the 15-yard line. First down now, but that clock rolling. And they get to him quickly here as he stopped right around the 13. 2 yards the gain on the keeper, and it's second down. Stroud. Dancing to his left. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked up by Kenny Moore. And the Lions are going to have the football at their own 1 yard line. The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. But the good news for them, they got the football. The bad news, they have to go 99 yards here as they start this drive out on their own 1 yard line. And he'll take this one up to about the 6 yard line. Joe Montana on second down. Right back to Cook for another completion. And he's able to get this one up to the 8 yard line this time. On third and short, they'll try and pick it up through the air. And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. They'll throw now on the final play. He's got a man complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before they reach the 50. And that'll do it for the end of the second quarter. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth ready for quarter number 3. The Lions in the lead, and they're going to get the football first as well as the second half is underway. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And able to take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. As this offense takes the field to begin the opening drive of the second half, Charles, remember in that first half, good through the air and really all around an outstanding offensive performance.
Absolutely. They reached the end zone several times. The passing game working awfully well. And most importantly, partner.
Yeah, they went to the tunnel with a lead. They come back out with that lead.
Absolutely. NFL coaches, we know they're perfectionists in a lot of ways, but they had to like what they saw in that first half.
Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down.
And Montana's going to shift things up a bit.
Now a play fake here on first down. Out to his left. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
I think he's as fine with that incompletion as a quarterback can be, in all honesty. He avoided his first sack of the game, and he did have a chance of connecting for yardage, just unable to on that throw.
On second down, Montana. That's caught by the Hall of Famer Marvin Harrison. And all the way inside the 15 before they drop it. So how about this for field position after the big play? Inside the 15 now as they come up on first and 10. Now they'll throw here out of the gun. Buying time to his left. And he'll protect himself at the end here as he winds up getting pretty decent yardage. He'll wind up getting 9 after tucking it and running, so it'll leave him with 2nd and a yard. They'll try the wide side with Cook. And he's going to take it in for a Lion touchdown.
Dalvin Cook taking it in from 4 yards out. And the Lions take the opening kickoff of the third quarter and drive right down the field to extend their lead. So the toss play effective, even down here near the goal line.
Yeah, and you're hoping the defense commits too many men to stop the run in the middle of the field and that your blockers can gain a little bit of an advantage. And when they do, foot race to the pylon, and this time, he had the speed to win that race.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And a decent return out to the 27-yard line. The Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going.
Well, the opposition laid down the challenge and opening drive touchdown here to start the second half. And, Charles, now you feel like this group needs to get an answer because this all of a sudden is a two-score game.
Yeah, you're right about that. What was a small, manageable spread to overcome? A little bit more daunting now. I think you're exactly right. Pressure is on because you don't want them getting the ball back with a chance to really extend this lead out.
As Stroud now to throw.
He's got his man. It's the tight end, Brevin Jordan. Big strides, look at him go. And all the way in for a Ravens touchdown. Brevin Jordan, 73 yards.
And the Ravens have got it back to within a score.
And remember, partner, that's a rookie quarterback back there. Apparently, he's getting the hang of this NFL thing pretty quickly.
Yeah, 3 touchdown passes. You're right. He looks comfortable. What are they doing? Anything in particular?
Well, they keep talking about making sure they're giving him plays that fit his talents and also maybe shrinking the playbook a little bit. They did tell us that. Bottom line, he's really good.
Point after, right down the middle. And they're within 7 now at 28-21. This game back within a touchdown now as the kickoff's away.
And all in all, a pretty solid return. Nearly got it to the 35. They'll mark him down officially at the 34.
The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. And their lead cut in half by that touchdown a moment ago. They are up 7 as they begin this drive, 1st and 10. And taken down just shy of the 40.
They're going to hurry back to the line now.
Here's Montana to throw. Flushed out right. And
seeing nowhere to throw, he chucks this one away from harm. Incomplete. Now it's third down.
Well, you most certainly don't want to go three and out here and get the football right back, because your friend, old momentum, he's wondering if he should change sidelines about right now. And if you don't convert here, guess what? He's going to make the trek to the opposite side, and all of a sudden, you got a battle on your hands.
Oh, he had a man open. He overshot him. It's incomplete.
Looked like they were set up defensively in a zone coverage, but somehow they found a seam, because that receiver, all alone by rights, that should have been a touchdown, but somehow this ball's overthrown.
Escaping the pressure right. And this is caught. It's pulled in by Gronkowski. And they're going to speed things up here. On first down, Montana. Got a man. It's Harrison. Complete. And they'll get this one down to about the 20-yard line. That's over 40 yards of movement with those last two plays. So both teams trade touchdowns, and the third is worth through three quarters of play. You are watching Madden Ultimate Team on EA Sports. Play fake. Now here's Montana rolling to his left. Looking left side. That's complete to Oliver. It'll be a gain of five, and that's going to bring up second down. They will look to throw. Montana eluding the pressure right. And this throw incomplete. And the defender all over him that time, and it's going to lead to third down.
As soon as he leaked out and began his route, someone on the defensive side broke with him and arrived just in time to separate him from another reception.
Montana forced out to his left. And he couldn't quite get there. Tackled down at the line. Montana, never a great runner of the football, but he's got a first down there. Well, there you go. Save your best scramble of the day for a big-time situation in the fourth quarter, picking up the first.
You don't want to use it up early, right? You want to make sure you save it for that exact moment, that key time, and that's what he did, although you and I both know it wasn't planned that way. But what a nice job using his eyes, scanning the field, and realizing when it was time to exit the pocket and go.
Cook looking for a signal, but none forthcoming. They stopped him shy of the goal line. If nothing else, they've already taken a couple minutes off the clock here already as they come up second down. Again, it's Cook, but he will lose yardage here. Back to the four-yard line. They'll wind up losing three, and now it's third down. To throw is Montana. Flush to his right. They have a man open, but he missed him, and it's incomplete. So it's been a long drive. They've held the ball for quite a while. Now what do you do here?
Well, to me, at this stage, after this drive, this close to the goal line, 3 points would be a letdown. I'm going for it here.
And the now 40-year-old veteran able to put this one through, and that will extend their lead even further. So that one, CD, going to make the road back a lot more difficult.
Oh, there's no doubt about that. You know they were praying on the other sideline for a miss, because now, as you pointed out, a very difficult road. Down two scores. You don't just need a touchdown. You need a chain of events to go your way. You've got to score, somehow get the ball back, and score again. The odds of that happening, not great in your favor.
They'll come up first and 10 here. Stroud working out of the gun. Flushed out right. On the run, he'll let this go deep right side. It's caught inside the 25. And he's going to be shoved out of bounds inside the 15-yard line. Time becoming a factor. Down two scores, though they have two timeouts and, of course, the two-minute warning to work with as well. Now here's Stroud looking end zone, but it's incomplete.
Had an open man that time, but ended up putting a little too much heat on it, don't you think, partner?
Absolutely. Just needed a touch more air under it. Instead, he fired an absolute bullet.
Once more from the 11, second and 10. Here's Stroud.
Got a man, it's caught for a Ravens touchdown. Vernon Davis, a beast in the red zone with his second touchdown of the game.
And the Ravens have made it a one-score game again here in the fourth.
So whatever happened to rookie quarterbacks taking time to adjust to life in the NFL? Because this guy looks like he's been doing it for about, what, 7 years? Four touchdown passes? That's not something rookies are supposed to be doing with the ease in which he's doing it.
Now a big play here as the Ravens are going to go for the two-point conversion.
Stroud's going to try to throw for the conversion.
Being chased out left. And unable to connect. They don't get the two-point conversion here.
I don't know about you, but I can't wait for a few years of two-point tries and see what the data tells us. Because a lot of teams want to throw the ball in this situation, this time unsuccessfully. I just wonder if maybe running the ball might be the way to go.
With it moved up from the 3 to the 2, you would think maybe a few more attempts at running.
I think stats over time may bear out that running the ball will at least be the equal of throwing it in that situation.
Here's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line.
Left side, Cook. And he's going to get it inside the 10 to the 7-yard line. So they come up on second down, and they can get another run like we just saw. Would likely put an end to this thing.
He's going to get it again. Just looking to get forward and protect the ball.
And this won't be enough to pick up the first. A gain of 2, 3rd and 1. They'll run it. Here's Cook. And that one going nowhere from the start as he's met in the backfield and goes backwards.
Just a simple run play there on 3rd and 1, but this D was up to the challenge and stopped him, bringing up 4th down.
Montana going for it on 4th.
Work in the middle of the field and he's got a man complete. And he will have a Lions 1st down, and that's the one that should seal a victory.
Cook. Stop him after a fairly minimal pickup. The Ravens going to use the 2nd of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 37 seconds to play. They try again with Cook. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Ravens going to use their 3rd and final timeout as they'll stop him with a little over 30 ticks to go in the football game. They'll run for it with Cook. Fighting for the end zone. He lost the football. It's out.
And now this ball picked up by the offense. But here in the final 2 minutes of the game, this will be blown dead. Only the fumbler can advance the football. So this will go back to the spot of the fumble itself.
So now one of the biggest kicks of the night is forthcoming. This will get the lead up to 7. And the 10-yard back knocks it through the goalpost. Fives for that one as that drive ends in 3. But from a defensive perspective, though, I think maybe they're saying, hey, we did what we needed to do, kept this a one-score game.
Yeah, without a doubt, because they were able to bleed some time off the clock, right? Put themselves in a good position, but it's not out of reach yet, okay? Being able to hold them to a field goal means that they do have a chance to come back and win this game.
And they'll be set up with good field position here as he gets this up over the 40-yard line. The Lions quickly now going to use the last of their timeouts. It'll be their 3rd and final timeout, so as they talk things over, we'll step aside.
Here's 1st and 10. Now Stroud.
On the move to his left.
Oh, and that's going to sabotage their comeback plans. It is intercepted.
Picked off by Stephon Gilmore. And they will finally stop him as he's down to the 40-yard line.
And the tough thing is when he goes back and reviews the film,
He'll see that he already escaped the pocket. He could have gotten more himself by using his legs, and that might have been the better choice there instead of challenging the zone. A miscalculation on his part, and he pays for it with the interception.
Now it looks like he'll throw here. It's complete to Cook. And he's across for a late touchdown. And in the final seconds, that one should just about put a camera on this game. So a little icing on the cake there before the clock hits all zeros.
What a way to finish things off. Exactly what you want. Not much time and a touchdown to put things away.
Extra point attempt here still to come. Oh, they flip it to the kicker. He looks like he's going to throw it. And it's caught inside the field. And he gets in. Well, no one was expecting a fake there, but they add two more onto their lead. I guess the touchdown wasn't enough. They want the onside kick as well. And this one recovered by the hands team for the Ravens. And as this defense walks off the field, they can do so with their heads held high. What a performance by the offense, too. I mean, really, Charles, just complete domination on both sides.